Hello friends, welcome to InfoNet coaching classes. In this video we are going to discuss the different prelims questions that were being asked in the previous years from the modern history context. And basically this video is the third part of our history question series, and hopefully you might have watched the rest two videos in which we have discussed the questions of the last 18 years, that is from 2018 till 2001. And basically in this video we are going to deal with the last 6 years questions, that is from 1995 till 2000. And please do watch this video till the end. And if you find it useful for yourself, then please do like, share and subscribe to our channel. Okay, so friends, let's get started. So this is the first question, as you can see on the screen. Which one of the following is not a feature of the Government of India Act of 1935? So this is a question basically which was being asked in the year 2000. And it says, which of these following four options is not a feature of the Government of India Act which was being passed in 1935? Options are, diarchy at the center as well as in the provinces, a bicameral legislature, provincial autonomy, or an all India federation. So of these four, the correct answer for this will be option number A, that is diarchy at the center as well as in the provinces. Okay, so this was the correct answer. This is because the diarchy was only introduced at the centers and not in the provinces. Okay, so diarchy was introduced in the provinces through the Government of India Act 1919 and not in the Government of India Act 1935. That's why this is not the feature of 1935. Moving on to next question. While delivering the presidential address, the Congress president who advocated the introduction of Roman script for Hindu language was, okay, so who was he? Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Abul Kalam Azad, or Subhash Chandra Bose? So the answer for this will be option number D, that is Subhash Chandra Bose. So basically while delivering the presidential address, that is in the year 1938, Subhash Chandra Bose advocated the introduction of Roman script for Hindi language. Okay, let's see the next question. Who among the following streamlined the third last Maratha administration after Sambhaji? So after Sambhaji, who was the third last Maratha administrator? Okay, so the options are Raja Ram, Balaji Vishwanath, Gangabai, or Nanaji Deshmukh. So the answer will be option number B, that is Balaji Vishwanath. So he was basically an efficient knowledge of both military and finance. He had a great knowledge of it, and he streamlined the Maratha administration after Sambhaji. Next question. Consider the following statements about Indian National Congress. The statements are, Sarojini Naidu was the first woman to be president of the Congress. C.R. Das was in prison when he functioned as the president of the Congress. The first Britishers to become the president of the Congress was Alan Octavian Hume, that is A.O. Hume. Or Alfred Webb was the president of the Congress in 1894. So of these statements, which one is correct? That is 1 and 3, 2 and 4, 2, 3 and 4, or 1, 2, 3 and 4. So the answer will be option number B, that is 2 and 4. Okay, this is because the first, as far as the first and third statements are concerned, so Sarojini Naidu was the second woman to be the president of Congress. The first was Annie Besant. So that's why the first statement is incorrect. And as far as the third statement is concerned, A.O. Hume was the founder of the Congress but never became the president of it. Okay, so that's why it is incorrect. Moving on to the next question. The Balkan plan for fragmentation of India was a brainchild of, so whose plan or whose idea was it? Options are W. Churchill, M.A. Jinnah, Lord Mountbatten, or V.P. Menon. So answer for this is option number C, that is Lord Mountbatten. Okay, so the Balkan plan. So basically it was the plan or it was the idea of Lord Mountbatten, and he was authorized by the British government to resolve the situation in India. Okay, so Mountbatten soon concluded the transfer of power from one central representative constituent assembly for India would be impossible to achieve, as neither an Indian National Congress nor the Muslim could agree terms and conditions for that. Okay, so that's why the plan was of Mountbatten. Moving on to the next question. At the time of partition of India, which one of the following provinces of British India came forward with a plan for a united and independent existence? Okay, so which part or which provinces came front for to be united or to remain independent existence? Okay, so the options are Punjab, Assam, Bengal, or Bihar. So the correct answer will be option number A, that is Punjab. So during the time of partition, when India was being divided into India and Pakistan, so Punjab province came forward with a plan for a united and independent existence, but it was due to the efforts of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel that PEPSU came into existence, consisting Eastern Punjab, Patiala and Hilly states. Okay, let's see the next question. It's a assertion region questions. Assertion says, the basic weakness of the early nationalist movement lay in this narrow social base. Reason is, it fought for the narrow interest of the social folks groups which joined it. Okay, so the quotes are, both A and R are individually true and R is the correct explanation. Both A and R are individually true but R is not the correct explanation. A is true but R is false, or A is false but R is true. So the answer for this will be option number C, that is A is true but R is false. The assertion is true but the reason for it is false, because early nationalists fought for the right of common people. Okay, so basically they fought for the right of common people, also for narrow interest of social groups that joined, but at that time their organization was weak and it could not be crushed by the British as per at any point of time, so they followed the method of prayer and petitions. Okay, so that's what the reason was, so it's incorrect. Let's see the next question. Lord Lithgow describes the August movement of 1942 as the most serious revolt after Sepoy mutiny. Reason is, peasants joined the movement in large number in some places. So is this the correct reason for the assertion, or it is true or false? So let's see the answer. So the answer will be option number A, that is both A and R are individually true and R is the correct explanation of A. Okay, so both assertion and reason are true and it is the correct explanation, because due to the involvement of peasants, the Quit India movement became one of the most biggest and most widest spread movement, okay, which is also commonly known as August movement. Okay, so this led Lithgow to call this the most serious movement after, or most serious revolt after Sepoy mutiny. Okay, moving on to the next question. Match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer. Okay, so list 1 says land allotted to big feudals. Option B, land allotted to revenue farmers of rent collectors. Land allotted to East peasants with the right to subdebt, mortgage, transfer, gift or sell. Revenue settlement made at a village. So which was it? In the list 2 it is given Jagirdari system, Rutbari system, Malwari system or Zamindari system. So the answer for this will be option B, that is 1, 4, 2 and 3. So the exact explanation is that basically land that were allotted to big feudal landlords was Jagirdari system. Lands that were allotted to revenue farmers or rent collectors who were zamindars was zamindari system, and the land allotted to East peasants with the right to sublet, mortgage, transfer, gift or sell was Rutbari system, and it was Malwari system in which the revenue system was made at the village level. Okay, so basically that's the right pairing. Next question, it's also a matching question, that is list 1 says Chittagong Armory Raid, Abhinav Bharat, Anushilan Samiti, Kuka movement, and in list 2 it's given Kalpana Dutt, Guru Ram Singh, Vikram Damodar Savarkar or Aurobindo Ghosh. So the options are A 1342, B 1324, C 3124 or D 3142. So the answer for this will be option number A, that is 1, 3, 4 and 2. Okay, so basically as far as this personalities are concerned, Kalpana Dutt is related to Chittagong Armory Raid under the leadership of Surya Singh. Abhinav Bharat was a revolutionary organization which was basically founded by Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. Aurobindo Ghosh was related to Anushilan Samiti, and Dawn Revolutionary Organization founded by Shishir Kumar Ghosh, and Kuka movement was led by Guru Ram Singh in Punjab. Okay, so that's the correct answer. Next question. After returning from South Africa, Gandhi launched his first successful satyagraha in which place? That is Chauri Chaura, Dandi, Champaran or Bardoli. So the answer for this will be option number C, that is Champaran. As we all know, his first satyagraha was at Champaran Satyagraha. So basically he returned from South Africa in 1915 and 1917 he launched his first successful satyagraha, which was in Champaran. Okay, so basically this satyagraha was against the indigo planters and the insistence of Rajkumar Shukla. Okay, so moving on to the next question. The native of Tripura became involved in the freedom movement early in the 20th century because, okay, so why was the natives of Tripura involved in the freedom movement? The king of Tripura was always anti-British. The British revolutionaries took shelter in Tripura. The tribes of the states were fiercely freedom loving, and they were already come groups fighting against kinship and protected the British. Okay, so the answer will be option number B, that is the Bengal revolutionaries took shelter in Tripura. So as we know, the native states Tripura became involved in the freedom movement because of the presence of Bengali revolutionaries who basically took shelter in Tripura. Or that's why, so they were automatically involved in it. Moving on to the next question. As an alternative to the partition of India, Gandhiji suggested to Mountbatten that what did he suggest? That is postpone granting of independence, invited Jinnah to form the government, invited Nehru and Jinnah to form the government together, or invited the army to take over for some time. So basically the suggestion that was being given by Gandhiji to Mountbatten was option B, that is he invited Jinnah to form the government. Okay, so mostly Gandhiji suggested to Mountbatten that he should invite Muhammad Ali Jinnah to form the government as an alternative to the partition of India. But this move or this step that he suggested was bitterly criticized by the Congress members. Okay, Moving on to the next question. The last major extension of British Indian territory took place during the time of, or during which time did the major extension that of the British, that took place of the British territory was, options are at the time of Dufferin, Dalhousie, Lytton or Curzon. So the answer will be option number A, that is Dufferin. So the last major extension was during the time of Dufferin, that is the annexation of Upper Burma in January 1886. Okay, next question. The Indian National Army INA they came into existence in 1943 in which of the this place did the Indian National Army came into existence? Options are Japan, Burma, Singapore or Malala. So the answer will be option C, that is Singapore. So the Indian National Army, which was an armed force formed by the Indian nationalists in the year 1942 in Southeast Asia during World War II. Okay, so the aim of army was to secure independence with Japanese assistance, with the help of Japanese, and initially formed in the year 1942. Immediately after the fall of Singapore under Mohan Singh, it was revived under the leadership of Subhash Chandra Bose in the year 1943. So basically it came into existence in Singapore in the year 1943. Let's see the next question. In this instance, we could not play off the Mohammedans against the Hindus. To which of the following events did this remark of Acheson's relate? Okay, so Acheson's remarks was this line which is given in the question, and to which event did he say this such? Okay, so that is the revolt of 1857, Champaran Satyagraha of 1917, Khilafat and Non-Cooperation Movement of 1992 to 1922, or August Movement of 1942. So the answer for this will be the revolt of 1857. So that is, in this revolt, as we all know, there was a Hindu-Muslim unity in this revolt, and it was indirectly acknowledged later by Acheson, a senior British officer, that he complained and said the above statement. Okay, so if this is going to be the condition, then we could not play off the Mohammedans against the Hindus. So that was his remarks or sayings that he gave during the time of the revolt. Okay, next question. Acheson, Lord Linlithgow described the August Movement of 1942 as the most serious rebellion since Sepoy Mutiny. Okay, reason says there was a massive upsurge of the peasantry in certain areas. Okay, so is the reason correct explanation for the Acheson? So let's see the answer. Option number B, that is both A and R are individually true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. So this is a repeated question, as we have already seen earlier. So the Quit India Movement or the August Movement, which was being started on 8th August 1942, had unprecedented involved for peasants or farmers community, and which made this struggle more fierce or more stronger. So thus Lord Linlithgow described this movement as the most serious rebellion since Sepoy Mutiny. Okay, moving on to the next question. The term imperial preference was applied to the, to which of the following, that is special privilege on British imports in India, racial discrimination of Britishers, subordination of Indian interest to that of British, preference given to British political agents over Indians. So the answer will be option number D, that is the preference given to British political agents over Indians. Okay, so basically the imperial preference was applied to the preference given to the political British political agents, and imperial preference historically a commercial arrangement in which preferential rates were granted to one another by constitution units of an empire. Okay, let's see the next question. It's a matching question, that is in list 1 it is given different years are there, and in list 2 there are certain events regarding the years. So 1775 1780 1824 1838, and the events are first Anglo-Burmese war, first Anglo-Afghan wars, first Anglo-Maratha war or second Anglo-Mysore war. So there are codes for it and we have to match it. So the answer for this is going to be option number C, that is 3, 4, 1 and 2. So basically the first Anglo-Burmese war was held in 1824. The first Anglo-Afghan war took place in the year 1838 to 1842 it was, and first Anglo-Maratha war was in the time period of 1775 to 82, and second Anglo-Mysore was Mysore war was in the time period of 1782-84. Okay, so that's the correct pairing. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following events. Certain events are being given here, that is Indigo Revolt, Santhal Rebellion, Deccan Revolt, Mutiny of the Sepoys, and we have to arrange them in the correct chronological order, in the order in which they have occurred. Okay, so option 1 says 4213, option B 4231, option C 2431, or option number D 2413. So the answer will be option number C, that is 2, 4, 3 and 1. Okay, so that's the correct order for it. So basically the Santhal revolution that took in place in the Rajmahal Hills under the leadership of Sidhu and Kanu, It was in the year 1855-56, and as we know, Sepoy Mutiny took place in the year 1857. Indigo River Fest took place in the year of 1857 as well in Bengal, and Deccan Riots that took place in the year 1875. Okay. In some parts of Pune and Satara district of Maharashtra. So that's the order of it. Okay, next question. Which one of the following Indian leaders was dismissed by the British from the Indian Civil Service? So who have been dismissed from out of these four from the ICS of by the Britishers? Okay, so options are Satyendranath Tagore, Surendranath Banerjee, R.C. Dutt or S.C. Bose. Okay, so the answer will be option number B, that is Surendranath Banerjee. So basically in the year 1869, Surendranath Banerjee became the second Indian to succeed to the ICS competitive exams. And later in the year 1874, he was being dismissed for a minor and apparently inadvertent procedural error, okay, mistake which he committed. And he had been discriminated because of non-Europeans and has been, and since he was being an Indian, so that's why he was being dismissed from the service. Moving on to the next question. Which one of the following leaders of Congress was totally in favor of cabinet mission plan? So who did support the cabinet mission plan out of these four? That is Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Patel or Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. So answer for this is going to be option number C, that is Sardar Patel. So Sardar Patel, as we know, a member of Congress, was totally in favor of cabinet mission plan. He favored the mission proposals according to which, with setting of a constitution assembly and interim government, the Muslim League will no longer hold the power of veto, and Indian seats will have to enter into treaties with the constituent assembly or interim government. So that's the reason why he had supported the mission. Okay, moving on to the next question. Which Indian nationalist leader looked upon a war between Germany and Britain as the godsend opportunity which would enable Indians to exploit the situation of their advantage? So options are C. Rajagopalachari, M. A. Jinnah, Subhash Chandra Bose or Jawaharlal Nehru. Okay, so answer will be option number C, that is Jawaharlal Nehru. So the deteriorating conditions of Europe during the Second World War made basically that subjugated colonies including India and sense of complete freedom. Okay, so Subhash Chandra Bose was eager to take advantage of this war effect, that is between Germany and Britain, and he thought it, or he imagined as it as a godsend opportunity for the Indians. Okay, moving on to the next question. At the time when empire in Europe was crumbling before the might of Napoleon, which one of the following governor general kept the British flag flying high in India? Okay, so the options are Warren Hastings, Lord Cornwallis, Lord Wellesley or Lord Hastings. Okay, so the answer will be option number D, that is Lord Hastings. So basically it was Lord Hastings through Anglo-Nepalese war that was being held during the time period of 1814 to 16, suppression of the Pindaris and at the end of Maratha Confederacy kept the British flag flying high in India. Okay, when empires in Europe were crumbling before the powers of Napoleon. Okay, let's see the next question. The Governor General who followed a spirited forward policy towards the Afghan wars. So who was he? Minto, Dufferin, Elgin or Lytton? So the answer will be option number D, that is Lytton. Okay, so English force was being defeated in the Anglo-Afghan wars that was held in 1839 to 1842. And Lord Ellenborough, who followed a forward policy towards Afghanistan to regain a lost prestige of the English force. Okay, and later on, Lord Lytton carried forward this policy. Okay, let's see the next question. It made its proposal in May. It still wanted a united India. There was to be a federal union composed of British provinces. So, of these above quotations that are being mentioned here, what does it signify, or to which mission or event does it refer to? That is Simmons Commission, Gandhi Irwin Pact, Phipps Mission or the Cabinet Mission. So answer for this is option number D, that is Cabinet Mission. Okay. So as we know, the Cabinet Mission's proposal came in May 1946, and which opposed the demand of Pakistan and supported a united India composed of British provinces. Okay, so that was the proposal of the Cabinet Mission. Yeah, moving on to the next question. The most short-lived of all the Britain's constitutional experiments in India was the, so which of these acts was the most short-lived? Indian Council Act of 1861, Indian Council Act of 1992, Indian Council Act of 1909 or Government of India Act of 1919. So answer will be option number C, that is Indian Council Act of 1909. Okay, so basically the act which we know commonly as the Morley Minto reforms was the most short-lived one, as late as the Government of India Act 1919, or which we call Montagu-Chelmsford Commission reforms, came forward in response to increase the demands of India for home rule. Okay, so that's why this Indian Council Act of 1909 was very short-lived. Moving on to the next question. Abhinav Bharat is a secret society of revolutionary which was organized by whom? That is Khudiram Bose, V.D. Savarkar, Prafulla Chakki or Bhagat Singh. So the answer will be option number B, that is V.D. Savarkar. So Abhinav Bharat Society was also known as Young India Society, and basically it was founded by V.D. Savarkar, or whom we call Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, and his brother, that is Ganesh Damodar Savarkar, and it was basically founded in the year 1903. Next question. There was no independent development of industries in India during British rule because of. So what was the reason behind which behind the fact that there was no independent development of industries at the time of British rule? So what was the reason for it? Absence of heavy industries, scarcity of foreign capital, scarcity of natural resources, preference of the rich to invest in land. So answer will be option number A, that is absence of heavy industries. Okay, so basically during the British period in India, there were complete negligence and high-handedness of British regime, and they did not establish any heavy industries at that time period. And after India's independence, the prime focus and attention was given to the development and promoting of heavy industries. Okay, next question. Maths list 1, that is Acts of Colonial Government of India, and list 2, that is Provisions. Okay, so in list 1, there are the name of certain persons like Shyamji Krishna Verma, Madam Bhikhaji Kama, Annie Besant, Aurobindo Ghosh, and in list 2 it's Vande Mataram, Indian Sociologist, the Talwar or Commonwealth. So these are the journals and the persons who released it. Okay, so the correct answer for this will be option number A, that is 2, 3, 4 and 1. So this is the correct explanation, that is Shyamji Krishna Verma, he published or he released India House, and Madam Bhikhaji Kama, the Talwar, Annie Besant, Commonwealth, and Aurobindo Ghosh, Vande Mataram. Okay, moving on to the next question. The Congress policy of prayer and petitions ultimately came to an end at the guidance of. So under whose guidance the policy of prayer and petitions, which was the policy of the moderates, okay, of the Congress policy, came to an end. So options are Aurobindo Ghosh, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajpat Rai, or option number D, that is Mahatma Gandhi. So answer will be option number B, that is Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So the partition of Bengal and Swadeshi movement marked the beginning of the new era in the history of Indian nationalism, and under the guidance of Bal Gangadhar Tilak, the policy of prayer and petition came to an end basically. Okay, next question. The first venture of Gandhi in All India Politics was the. So which was the first event or first venture of Gandhi in All India Politics? Options are Non-Cooperation Movement, Rowlatt Act, Champaran Movement or Dandi March. So the answer will be option number B, that is Rowlatt Satyagraha. Okay, so basically as we know, Gandhiji had began his journey or experiments with Satyagraha in Champaran, and he started the Champaran movement in 1917, then Ahmedabad movement, Ahmedabad Satyagraha in 1918, and Kheda Satyagraha in 1918 as well. So these movements or these Satyagraha were very localized and confined to regions only. Okay, but the first all India level movement launched by him was the Satyagraha against the Rowlatt Act in March 1919. So that's why the Rowlatt Satyagraha was the first venture when he entered into All India Politics. Okay, let's see the next question. Who was the leader of the Gadar Party? So basically there are four options like Bhagat Singh, Lala Hardayal, Bal Gangadhar Tilak or V.D. Savarkar. Who was the leader of it? So the answer will be option number B, that is Lala Hardayal. Okay, so basically the original name of Gadar Party was the Pacific Coast Hindustan Association. Okay, please remember this. And the founding president of Gadar Party was Sohan Singh Bhakhana, and Lala Hardayal was the co-founder of the party. Okay, so headquarters of this movement or this party was set up at Yugantar Ashram in San Francisco, which is in North America. Okay, let's see the next question. The Congress is tottering to its fall, and one of my greatest ambitions while in the India is to assist it in a peaceful demise. The statement is attributed to whom? Like Lord Dufferin, Lord Curzon, Lord Lytton or none of the above. The answer will be option number B, that is Lord Curzon. Okay, so Lord Curzon did quote these statements. Okay, next question. Which of the following pairs is correctly matched? Okay, so first is Theodore Beck, Elbert Bill, Firuza Mehta, Badruddin Tyabji. In the second column it's given Mohammedan Anglo Oriental College Aligarh, Lord Ripon, Indian National Congress or Muslim League. Okay, so what will be the correct combinations? Let's see. So option number D, it's 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so these three pairs have been correctly matched, and fourth option is incorrect. Okay, because as we know, Theodore Beck, who was the first principal of Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College, in that way he is related to it, and Lord Ripon, he had passed the Hilbert Bill in the year 1883. Firuza Mehta was one of the founding members of Indian National Congress, and Bahruddin Tyabji, okay, he was the first Muslim president of Indian National Congress in the year 1887. Okay, so he was not related to Muslim League, rather he was related to the Congress. Okay, next question. Which of the following defines the extremist ideology during the early phase of Indian freedom movement? Okay, options are stimulating the production of indigenous articles by giving them preference over imported commodities, obtaining self-government by aggressive means in place of petitions and constitutional ways, providing national education according to the requirements of the country, organizing co-ops against the British Empire through military revolt. So of this, which actually defines the extremist ideology during the freedom movement? Okay, so the answer will be option B, that is obtaining self-government by aggressive means in place of petitions and constitutional ways. So the extremist believed in giving or fighting against the Britishers by aggressive means, okay, and not by petitions and other constitutional ways. Okay, next question. What is the correct sequence of the following events? So there are four events and we have to arrange them in the correct chronological order. Events are the August offer, the INA trial, the Quit India movement, the Royal Indian Naval Ratings revolt. Okay, so the answer will be option A, that is 1, 3, 2 and 4. Okay, so the August offer was the first to come, that is in the year 1940, Quit India movement in the year 1942, the INA trial was in the year 1945, and the Royal Indian Naval Revolt which took place was in 1946. Okay, moving on to the next question. Which one of the following events was criticized by Montagu as the preventive murder? Okay, so killing of INA activities, massacre of Jallianwala Bagh, shooting of the Mahatma, shooting of the Curzon White. Okay, so answer will be option will be, that is massacre of Jallianwala Bagh. So this was severely criticized by Edwin Montagu, and he called it as preventive murder. Okay, moving on to the next question. The Indian Muslim in general were not attracted to the extremist movement because of. So what was the reason why the Indian Muslims were not attracted to the extremist movement? Options are influence of the Sayyid Ahmad Khan, anti-Muslim attitude of extremist leader, indifference shown to Muslim aspirations, extremist policy of harping on Hindus' past. Okay, so the answer will be option number D, that is the extremist policies of harping on Hindus' past. Okay, so basically the Hindus, what they did was they celebrated Shivaji Jayanti, Ganesh Utsav, there was celebration by Tilak and holy dip in the sacred rivers during the Swadeshi movement, and it did not attracted the mass of the Muslims. Okay, because the extremists, they gave more importance to the Hindus' past, okay, or Hindus' ancient times or their events. Okay, now moving on to the next question. Simon's Commission of 1927 was boycotted because. So why was it boycotted? So this is a very common question, and this has been repeated in most of the years. And as we all know, so the options, it says there are no Indian members in the commission. It supported the Muslim League. Congress felt that people of India are entitled to Swaraj, or there was difference among members. So the answer will be option A, that is there were no Indian members in the commission. As we all know, there were a group of seven British members in the parliament under the chairmanship of Sir John Simon. They assisted by Clement Attlee. They had to come to India, and its main objective was to report on the Indian constitutional progress for introducing the constitutional reforms as it has been promised before. Okay, so as there were no Indians, it was completely boycotted by the Indian mass. Okay, let's see the next question. What is the correct sequence of the following events? So the events are Tilak Shamrul League, Komakata Maru incident, Mahatma Gandhi's arrival in India. So of this, which is the correct code, or which is the correct chronological order? That is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3 or 2, 3, 1. So the correct order will be option number D, that is 2, 3 and 1. Okay, so that is the Komakata Maru which took place in the year 1914. And Mahatma Gandhi's arrival in India was in 1915, and Home Rule League, which was being established by Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Annie Besant, and it was being established in the year 1916. Okay, so that's the correct sequence for it. Next question. At the time of India's independence, Mahatma Gandhi was, so who was he at the time of independence? That is a member of the Congress Working Committee, not a member of the Congress, the President of the Congress, the General Secretary of the Congress. Okay, so the answer will be option number B, that is he was not a member of the Congress. Okay, so basically the president of Indian National Congress during 1947 was J.B. Kripalani. As we know, Mahatma Gandhi was not a member, and because he was a mentor for national policy formation. Okay, and basically he also had presided over only one session, and that is the Belgaum session, and the rest of the time he was not a member of the Congress. Okay, let's see the next question. The Indian National Congress agreed in 1947 to of the country mainly because the principle of two nation theory was then acceptable to them. It was imposed by the British government and Congress was helpless in this regard. They wanted to avoid large scale communal riots, or India wanted would have otherwise lost the opportunity to attain freedom. So what was the reason behind which the Indian National Congress agreed to the partition of the country? Okay, so the answer will be option number C, that is they wanted to avoid large scale communal riots, because by that time there were rise of communal riots and a state of confusion and communal disharmony which was spreading very fast, and to check this the Congress leaders agreed to they were being forced to agree to the partition of India. Okay, moving on to the next question. When the Indian Muslim League was inducted into the interim government in 1946, Liaquat Ali Khan was assigned the portfolio of which of the following, that is Foreign Affairs, Home Ministry, or Finance, or Defense. Okay, so of these four ministries, Liaquat Ali Khan was assigned to which of these? Okay, so answer will be option number C, that is Finance. Okay, so basically the Foreign Affairs Ministry was being assigned to Jawaharlal Nehru, the Home Ministry was given to Vallabhbhai Patel, and Defense Ministry was assigned to Baldev Singh. Okay, so it was the interim government which took place in the year 1946. Let's see the next question. Assertion: Gandhiji stopped the non-cooperation movement in 1922. Violence at Chauri Chaura led him to stop the movement. Okay, so is this the correct reason for it? So let's see the answer. The answer will be option A, that is both A and R are individually true and R is the correct explanation of A. So it's the correct exact explanation for the assertion. So as we know, the Chauri Chaura incident, which occurred at Chauri Chaura in Gorakhpur district on 5th February 1922, when a large group of protesters were participating in non-cooperation movement, clashed with the police and opened fire at the police station in retaliation. Okay, so in this, they set fire to the police station and killed some of the police officials, and this was the reason for which there was violence all around, and Gandhiji had to stop the non-cooperation movement. Let's see the next question. The Congress rejected the Cripps proposal, and the reason is the Cripps mission consisted solely of whites. Okay, so let's see the answer. It's option number B, that is both A and R are individually true, but it's not the correct explanation of the assertion. Okay, so basically the Cripps proposal was rejected, and it was rejected as Congress was demanding for complete independence. Okay, whereas Cripps proposal was meant for dominion status of India. So that's the reason why it was rejected. Next question. The first ever bill to make primary education compulsory in India was rejected in the year 1911, and the reasons for it is discontent would have increased in every culverts could read. Okay, so answer will be option A, that is it's the correct explanation for the assertion, that is the British government rejected the first bill to make primary education compulsory in India as it had feared that it might spread the discontent among the people. Okay, so it's the correct reason for it. Next question. Partition of Bengal in 1905 brought to an end of the moderate role in India freedom movement. The reason is the Surat session of Indian National Congress separated the extremists from the moderates. So as far as this is concerned, which of the option will be correct? Let's see. It is option number D, that is A is false, that the assertion is false, and but the reason which is given R is true. Okay, so basically as we know, moderates continued to participate in the struggle for freedom even after the partition of Bengal, that is after 1905, and later in 1916 both the groups reunited in the Lahore session that took place in 1916. Okay, that's why the first assertion is incorrect and the reason is absolutely correct. Next question. The Khilafat movement did not bring the urban Muslims into the fold of national movement. Reason says there was a predominant element of anti-imperialism in both national and Khilafat movement. So let's see the answer. It's A. Both A and R are individually true, and R is the correct explanation of A. So it's the exact explanation. This was the reason why the Khilafat movement did not bring into its fold. Okay. Next question. Lord Mountbatten came to India as a viceroy along with the specific instruction to. For what did he came to India? That is, balkanize the Indian subcontinent, keep India united if possible, accept Jinnah's demand for Pakistan, persuade the Congress to accept partitions. Okay, so what was the reason behind which Lord Mountbatten came to India with which intentions? Okay, so the answer will be option number B, that is to keep India united if possible. Okay, so he came with a specific instruction and overseeing the transition of British India to independence no later than 30 June 1948. Okay, next question. The educated middle class in India, what did they do? They opposed the revolt of 1857, they supported the revolt of 1857, or they remained neutral to the revolt of 1857, or fought against the native rulers? So the answer for this is option number C, that is they remained neutral to the revolt of 1857. Okay, because they thought that they were in favor of the Britishers, because they imagined or they thought that they will lead them to the developed nation and would certainly grant them the self control or self ruling of the country. Okay, one day. So next question. Match list one, select the answers using the code given below the list. Okay, so the list says Mofala revolt, Pavna revolt, Eka movement, Birsa Munda revolt. So there are certain revolts, and with which region are they associated with? That is Kerala, Bihar, Bengal, or Awadh. So options are A 1342, B 2341, C 1234, or 3412. So the answer will be option number A, that is 1, 3, 4, and 2. Okay, so basically the Mofla revolt, which occurred in the Malabar in the year 1921, led by Ali Muslihar and Varian Kutian Haji. Okay, and as far as the Pavna revolt is concerned, it occurred in Bengal from the year 1873 to 76, and it was basically a resistance movement by the peasants. And Eka movement, which took place, it is also known as Unity movement, and in fact it is also peasant movement, which took place in United Provinces in the year 1921. Okay, and finally the Birsa Munda revolt, it was led by Birsa Munda in the areas of modern day Bihar and Jharkhand in the year 1890s. Okay, next question. Which is the correct chronological sequence of the following? So there are certain events like Wood's education dispatch, Macaulay's minute on education, the Sargent education report, or Indian education, or Hunter's commission, which we call commonly. Okay, so of this, which is the current correct sequence? That is 2143, 2134, 1243, or 4312. So the answer is going to be option number A, that is 2, 1, 4, and 3. Because Macaulay's minutes on education, it was in the year 1835. That you can say Wood's education dispatch, it was in the year 1854. Hunter's commission came in 1882. Okay, and the Sargent's plan on education, it came in the year 1944. Okay, so that's the correct sequence of it. Next question. M.C. Stalwarts, B.N. Rao, and Alladi Krishnaswamy Iyer were distinguished members of which of the following parties? Okay, so the options are Swaraj Party, All India National Liberal Federation, Madras Labour Union, Servants of India Society. So the answer is option number D, that is the Servants of India Society. So Servants of India Society, as we know, it was formed by Gopal Krishna Gokhale in the year 1905 in Pune, Maharashtra, who left the Deccan Education Society to form this association. Okay, so basically G.K. Gokhale left the Deccan Education Society to form Servants of India Society. Next question. Match list 1 with list 2. That is, list 1 says Chittagong Armory Raid, Kakori Conspiracy, Lahore Conspiracy, Kadar Party. And in list 2 it's given Lala Hardayal, Jatin Das, Surya Sen, Ram Prasad Bismil, or Vasudev Phakde. So which of these personalities were associated with which of these events or conspiracy that took place? Okay, so the answer will be option number C, that is 3, 4, 2, and 1. So basically, this is the correct matching, that is Chittagong Armory Raid. It took place in Bengal under the leadership of Surya Sen, as we know. Saharpur to Lucknow train was looted at Kakori under the leadership of Ram Prasad Bismil in the year 1925. So it's the Kakori conspiracy case. And Jatin Das was the first martyr who died on 64th day of his fast. He was tried in Lahore conspiracy case along with Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, and Sukhdev on April 1929. And finally, Gadar Party, which was established by Lala Hardayal and Sohan Singh Bhankna in 1913 at San Francisco. So, in this way, they are related to these conspiracies or events. Next question. It's also a matching question. List 1 says Surat Spirit, Communal Awards, All Party Convention, Pune Swaraj Resolution. And as far as these events are concerned, in which year did they take place? That is in 1929, 1928, 1932, 1907, or 1905. So the answer will be option number B, that is 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, so as far as this matching is concerned, as we know, the famous Surat split that took place in the Congress and it gave rise to two groups, that is moderates and extremists. It occurred in the year 1907. And next, the communal award was made by the British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald on the 16th August 1932. The All Party Convention, a series of conventions which took place in the year 1928 and which brought together the representatives of various political parties and communities in India, and the Purna Swaraj resolution, which was declared by Indian National Congress under the leadership of Gandhiji, Jawaharlal Nehru and other leaders. Okay, so this is the correct matching pair. Next question. The Pune Pact, which was being signed between the British government and Mahatma Gandhi in 1934, provided for. So what are the provisions of the Pune Pact? Okay, options are the creation for dominion status for India, separate electorates for the Muslims, separate electorates for the Harijans, or joint electorates with reservation of Harijans. So the answer will be option number D, that is the joint electorates with reservations of Harijans. Okay, so basically this pact was signed between Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and Mahatma Gandhi in the year 1934. Next question. Match list 1 is list 2. There are certain events and their results. So events are Moulay Minto reforms, Simon's Commission, the Chauri Chaura incident and Dandi March. Results for these are country was agitation, withdrawal of a movement, communal electorates, communal outbreaks, illegal manufacture of salt. So with which events, with which result are these events related with? Okay, so options are 3452, 4123, 2345 or 3125. So the answer is going to be option number B, that is 4, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so basically if we look at this matching, the Moulay Minto reforms, which was being introduced in the year 1909, for the first time it provided for separate electorates for Muslim category, and it is basically known as communal electorate. Okay, and the Simon's Commission, which has been appointed in the November 1927, and it was a government, it was sent by the British government to report on the working of Indian constitution by the government of Indian Act 1919. Okay, so it had no Indian members, so it was being rejected. And as far as the Chauri Chaura incident is concerned, it occurred at Gorakhpur district on 5th February 1922 and it led to the death of 3 civilians and 23 policemen, and finally it resulted with the halt, and it halted, and sorry, Gandhiji halted the non-cooperation movement as a result of this incident. Okay, and finally the Dandi March, which took place in 1930, it witnessed illegal procurement of salt, and afterwards civil disobedience movement was being conducted. So that's the correct matching for it. Next question. Who among the following was associated with the suppression of thugs? Okay, so options are General Henry Prendergast, Captain Slimer, Alexander Bones or Captain Robert Pemberton. So the answer for this is option would be, that is Captain Slimer. So basically his name was Sir William Henry Slimer, is best known for his duty for the suppressing of the thugs across the country. That is in 1835 he captured Syed Amir Ali and many other notorious leaders, okay, who were generally known as thugs. Next question. A graduate, so it's a question about a personality, a description about a personality. So a graduate at 18, professor and associate editor of the Sudharak at 20, secretary of the Sarvajanik Sabha and the Provincial Conference at 25, secretary of the National Congress at 29, leading witness before any important royal commission at 31, provincial legislature at 34, imperial legislature at 36, president of Indian National Congress is 39. So there are many such events or many such titles which are being associated with the person, and he was basically a patriot who Gandhiji himself regarded as his master. So who was he? That is Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, Mahadev Gobind Ranade, Gopal Krishna Gokhale or Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So the answer will be option C, that is Gopal Krishna Gokhale. So basically he was a very famous personality, and he was born in Kolhapur, that is in Maharashtra, in the year 1866. And even Gandhiji regarded him as his master. So he was such a personality. Moving on to the next question. Matching. So the options are, list 1 says Butler Committee Report, Hartung Committee Reports, Hunter Inquiry Committee Report or Moodyman Committee Report. Okay. And it's related to, that is in list 2 it's given Jallianwala Bagh Massacre, relationship between the Indian states and paramount power, working of the hierarchy as laid down in the Montagu Chamberlain reforms, the growth of education in British India and potentialities of its further progress. So the correct matching will be option number D, that is 2, 4, 1 and 3, that is the Butler committee report, and it's the relationship between the Indian states and paramount power. Hartung committee reports, that was that came in 1929, it's to give its report on the growth of education in British India, and Hunter commission or Hunter inquiry committee report in 1919, it was on Jallianwala Bagh Massacre, and Moodyman committee, finally it was on to report the duty, to report the working of the diarchy. Okay, next question. Who among the following suggested the winding of the Indian National Congress after the India attained independence? So after the attainment of independence, who gave suggestions to wind up the Indian National Congress? So options are C. Rajagopalachari, B. Acharya Kripalani, C. Mahatma Gandhi or Jayaprakash Narayan. So answer is option number C, that is Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. So Gandhi had asked Ali and the top Congress leaders to dissolve the party and to form a new organization in the purpose of serving the people. Okay, he told them that the task of INC or Indian National Congress was to fight for the freedom and liberation of India from the cycles of British, which was achieved by that time. Okay, so after the achievement of independence, he just suggested to wind up the party. Next question. Which of the following is an important historical novel written during the later half of the 19th century? Okay, so the options are Rashtragupter, Durgesh Nandini, Simarata or Nivandhamala. So answer will be option number B, that is Durgesh Nandini. Okay, so it is an important historical novel which was written during the later half in 19th century, and these were great historical novels written by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. Okay, and all these works and Durgesh Nandini dealt mostly with the condition and suppressive nature of British rule in India. Okay, moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements, that is the non-cooperation movement led to the led to which of these following, that is Congress becoming a mass movement for the first time, growth of Hindu-Muslim unity, removal of fear of the British might from the minds of the people, British government's willingness to grant political concession to India. So of this given statements, which one is correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 and 3 are correct, 1 and 3 are correct, or 3 and 4 are correct. So the answer is option number B, that is 2 and 3 are correct. On the second and third statements are correct, because it aimed to resist British rule in India though non-violent means. The idea of Ahimsa and non-violence and Gandhi's ability to rally hundreds of thousands of common citizens towards the cause of independence was first seen on a large scale. Okay, by this time. Next question. It's also a matching question, that is list ones. There are certain periods or times, years given, and in list two there are certain events. Okay, so which of these events is related to which years, that is you have to match it. Okay, so periods are 1883, 1906, 1927, 1932. And events are announcement of communal award for Whitehall, formation of All India State People's Conference, foundation of Muslim League at Dhaka, or first session of National Conference at Calcutta. So answer will be option number C, that is 4, 3, 2 and 1. Okay, so basically the first session of National Congress at Calcutta was held in the year 1883, foundation of Muslim League in Dhaka was in the year 1906, formation of All India State People's Conference was in the year 1927. And the announcement of communal award by Ramsay MacDonald from Whitehall was in the year 1932. Okay, next question. It's also a matching question. List one, Avinav Bharat Society, Anusilan Samiti, Gadar Party, Swaraj Party. Okay, so these are certain parties or societies, groups. And with this group, which of these personalities were associated with, like Sri Aurobindo Ghosh, Lala Hardayal, C.R. Das or V.D. Savarkar? So the answer for this is option number B, that is 1, 4, 3 and 2. Okay, so that is Avinav Bharat Society. It was a secret society which has been founded by Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, or V.D. Savarkar as we know, and his brother Ganesh Damodar Savarkar in the year 1993. As far as the Anushilan Samiti is concerned, it was a Bengali Indian organization that existed in the first half of 20th century. Okay, and it was basically led by Aurobindo Ghosh and his brother Varindra Ghosh. And Gadar Party, which was organized in San Francisco by Lala Hardayal and Sohan Singh Bhanka. And finally, the Swaraj Party was founded as the Congress Khilafat Swaraj Party by Chittaranjan Das and Motilal Nehru. Okay, so moving on to the next question. Which one of the following is not correct about the cabinet mission plan? So as far as the cabinet mission plan is concerned, which of these following options is not related or not correct to it? Okay, so provincial grouping, interim cabinet of Indians, acceptance of Pakistan, constitution framing rights. Okay, so answer is option number C, that is the acceptance of Pakistan. So basically the cabinet mission plan recommended an undivided India. Okay, and it did not support the acceptance of Pakistan as a new nation, or it did not support the partition of India. Okay, so basically this mission was turned down by the Muslim League, and they demanded for Pakistan. Okay, next question. Consider the following statements about Jawaharlal Nehru. Okay, so there are certain statements regarding Jawaharlal Nehru. Like, he was the president of Congress Party in 1947. He presided over the Constituent Assembly. He formed the first Congress Ministry in United Provinces before India's independence. So of these statements, which are correct, that is 1, 2 and 3. 1 and 3 are correct, 1 and 2 are correct, or none of this is correct. So So answer is option number D, that is none of these statements given about Jawaharlal Nehru is correct, because in 1947 Nehru was not the president, rather J.B. Kripalani was the president, and Dr. Rajendra Prasad presided over the Constituent Assembly, and it was not Jawaharlal Nehru. And Gobind Vallabh Pant formed the first Congress ministry in the United Provinces before independence. So that's why all the three statements are incorrect. Moving on to the next question. Match list 1 to list 2. List 1 says Surendranath Banerjee, M.K. Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, Lajpat Rai. Okay, list 2, Hind Swaraj, the Indian struggle, autobiographical writings, a nation in making. So we have to match it. So the answer for this is going to be option number C, that is 4, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so that is Surendranath Banerjee, a nation is making, M.K. Gandhi, Hind Swaraj, these are the books or the writings of these personalities, Subhash Chandra Bose, the Indian struggles, Lala Lajpat Rai, autobiographical writings. Okay, next question. Consider the following landmarks in Indian education. These were certain events or these were the landmarks or institutes that have been established as far as the Indian education context is concerned. And these are Hindu College, Calcutta, Universities of Calcutta, Adams Report, Wood's Dispatch. So what is the correct chronological order for these landmarks? Okay, so options are 1, 3, 4 and 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 3, 1, 4, 2 or 3, 2, 4, 1. So the answer is option number B, that is 1, 4, 3 and 2. Okay, so basically the Hindu College, it was established in the year 1817. William Adams reports in 1835, 1836 and 1838. Okay, Wood's Dispatch came into existence in the year 1854. And thereafter, the Calcutta University was established in the year 1857. Okay, next question. Who among the following was the prominent leaders of the Congress Socialist Party? So, as far as the Congress Socialist Party is concerned, who were a important leader of it? So, options are M.N. Roy, Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi, Pattam Thanu Pillai, Acharya Narendra Dev. Okay, so the answer is option number D, that is Acharya Narendra Dev. So, basically, Acharya Narendra Dev, Minu Masani, and Jayaprakash Narayan were the pioneers of the Congress Socialist Party, and it was formed in the year 1934 as a result or as a consequence of the civil disobedience movement. It is because or due to the failure of civil disobedience movement. Okay, moving on to the next question. The meeting of Indian and British political leaders during 1930 to 1932 in London has often been referred to as the first, second and third round table conferences. Okay, so as we know, there were three round table conferences, and it will be incorrect to refer to them as such because the Indian National Congress did not take part in two of them. Indian parties other than Indian National Congress participating in the whole conference represented the sectional interest and not the whole of India. The British Labour Party and withdrawn from the conference, thereby making the proceeding the conference party is partitioned. It was an instance of the conference held in three sessions and not that of three separate conferences. Okay. So the answer is option number D, that is it was an instance of conference held in generally three sessions and it was not of three separate conferences. Okay. And basically it was held to discuss the Simons Commission report and further course of action on it. Okay, moving on to the next question. Who among the following was the first European to initiate the policy of taking part in the quarrel of Indian princes with a view to acquire territories? Okay, so the options are Clive, Dupleix, Albuquerque or Warren Hastings. So the answer is option number B, that is Dupleix. Okay, so basically as we know that the French used to provide their troops for the rent purpose to the native Indian states. Okay, and Dupleix was the first who lent their European troops to the Indian state in the matter of quarrels. Okay, so that's right, it's the right answer. Moving on to the next question. The following advertisement. So there's an advertisement, context of the advertisement, that is the marvel of the century, the wonder of the world, living photography pictures of life-size reproductions by Messrs. Lumiere Brothers. Cinematographic, a few expedition will be given at Watson's Hotels tonight. So this appeared in the Times of India, dated 7th August, in which year? That is 1931, 1929, 1921 or 1896. So the answer is option number D, that is 1896. So on 7th July 1896, the Lumiere Brothers showcased 6 films at Watson Hotel in Bombay, and the mentioned details was the first advertisement of Indian cinema in Times of Indian newspaper. Okay, let's see the next question. The Anarchical and Revolutionary Crime Act 1919 was popularly known as. So this act was popularly known by which of the following name? That is Rowlatt Act, Pitt's India Act, Indian Arms Act or Ilbert Bill. Okay, the answer will be option number A, that is the Rowlatt Act. So basically the Anarchical and Revolutionary Crime Act of 1919 was passed by a committee under the chairmanship of Justice Sidney Rowlatt. Okay, so that's why this act was popularly known as Rowlatt Act, and it was considered as a black act by Gandhiji because The act allowed the government machineries to take certain political cases to be tried without juries. Okay, so that's the reason behind the roulette act. Okay, moving on to the next question. B.R. Ambedkar was elected to the Constituent Assembly from which of these following places? That is West Bengal, the Bombay Presidency, the then Madhya Bharat, or Punjab. So the answer is option number A, that is West Bengal. So though he was a resident of Bombay Presidency, he was not elected from there, and rather he was elected from West Bengal. Okay, moving on to the next question. Who among the following leaders did not believe in the drain theory of Dadabhai Naroji? As we all know that Dadabhai Naroji has given the drain of wealth theory, and who did not believe in it? So options are B.G. Tilak, R.C. Dutt, M.G. Ranade, or Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Okay, so the answer is option number D, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Okay, he did not believe in the drain theory. Okay, so because he was loyal to British and was opposed to Congress ideas of self-rule and to the death of English Empire. Okay, next question. His principal fault was social and religious reforms. He relied upon legislations to away with social ills and worked unceasingly for the eradication of children, child marriage, the purdah system. So these were of the works of whom? To encourage consideration of social problems of a national scale, he inaugurated the Indian National Social Conference, which for many years met for its annual session alongside the Indian National Congress. So as far as this passage is concerned, it is referred to whom? Which of the following person? That is Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, Bahramji Marwanji Malwari, Mahadev Govind Ranade, or B.R. Ambedkar. So the answer is option number C, that is Mahadev Govind Ranade or M.G. Ranade, as we know. Okay. So basically, Indian National Social Conference was inaugurated by Mahadev Govind Ranade, and he was also the founder of Social Conference Movement. Okay. Moving on to the next question. Assertion: the British sovereignty continued to exist in free India. The reason is the British sovereign appointed the last Governor General of Free India. So in this context of the two statements, which of the following is correct? So both A and R are correct, or R is the correct explanation or not, or A is true but R is false, or A is false but R is true. So of these four options, which is the correct one? That is option number D, that is assertion is false but the reason behind it is true. Okay. So basically, India became sovereign nation on, as we know, 15th August 1947. However, Lord Mountbatten, as the last Governor General of Free Independent India, was appointed by the British sovereign. Okay, next question. Which one of the following first mooted the idea of Constituent Assembly to frame a constitution for India? So, options are Swaraj Party in 1934, Congress Party in 1936, Muslim League in 1942, or All India Conference in 1946. Okay, so basically the answer is option number A, that is Swaraj Party in 1934. So the idea of constituting a constituent assembly was first discussed or first given by the Swaraj Party in the year 1935, and the idea was being proposed by M.N. Roy, as we all know. Okay, next question. It's a matching question with we have to match the list one to the list two. So the list one says number A, Governor General of Presidency of Fort William in Bengal under Regulating Act 1717, Governor General of India under Charter Act 1883, Governor General and Viceroy of India under Indian Council Act 1858, Governor General and Crown Representative under Government of India Act 1935. So list 2 is Archibald Percival Wavell, Viscount and Earl Wavell, James Andrew Brown Ramsay, Earl and Marquess of Dalhousie, Charles Cornwallis II, Earl and First Marquess of Cornwallis, Gilbert John Elliot Murray, Kinelmont, Earl of Minto, or Louis Mountbatten, Earl Mountbatten of Burma. So which of these person were related to the given options in list 1? Okay, so the answer will be option number A, that is 3, 2, 4, and 1. That's the correct matching for it. So the Governor General of Presidency of Fort William in Bengal, that is Lord Cornwallis, this is from 1786 to 93, and Governor General of India Lord Dalhousie from 1848 to 56, Governor General and Viceroy of India Lord Minto from 1905 to 1910, and Governor General and Crown Representatives was Lord Wavell, that is 1943 to 1947. Okay, so moving on to the next question. The Sarbandi or No Tax campaign of 1992 was held by whom? Okay, that is Bhagat Singh, Chittaranjan Das, Rajguru, or Vallabhbhai Patel. The answer is option number D, that is Vallabhbhai Patel. So basically in Gujarat, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel led this campaign, that is No Tax campaign or Sarbandi campaign, and he emphasized the potential hardships and the need for complete unity and non-violence. Okay, next question. Hooghly was used as a base for piracy of the Bay of Bengal by whom? That is the Portuguese, the French, the Danish or the British. Okay, so answer is option number B, that is the French. So basically Hooghly became a center of piracy due to British East India Company vanished the influence of Portuguese trade in region. So dacoits, confiscation and capture of goods were increased in this part. Okay, moving on to the next question. Which of the following pairs are not correctly matched? So of these following four options, which one is not correctly matched? So options are Jamnalal Bajaj, Satyagraha Ashram at Wardha, Dadabhai Naroji, Bombay Association, Lala Lajpat Rai National School at Lahore, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, that is Satya Sodhak Samaj. So the answer for this is option number D, that is Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Satya Sodhak Samaj. So this is the incorrect matching as far as this is concerned. So Satya Sodhak Samaj is a social reform society which was basically established by Jyotirao Phule in Pune, and it was not Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Okay, and its purpose was to liberate Shudra and that is Shudras and untouchables caste from exploitation and oppression. Okay, moving on to the next question. In 1930, Mahatma Gandhi started civil disobedience movement from which of these following areas, that is Sevagram, Dandi, Sabarmati or Wardha? So the answer is option number B, that is Dandi. So basically Mahatma Gandhi started Dandi March, and it was significant in terms of breaking the salt law and beginning the civil disobedience movement, and it started in the year 1930 as we all know. Okay, let's see the next question. Which of the following political parties is that the national political parties, that is Muslim League, Revolutionary Socialist Party, All India Forward Bloc or Peasants and Workers Parties of India? So the codes are 1, 2 and 3, 2 and 4, 3 only or none of this. So the answer for this is option number D, that is none of this. So these all parties that has been given here were regional parties. Okay, regional level political parties during the pre-independence type of India. And however, only Indian National Congress, which was mass level presence almost entire nation, was the only national party by that time. Okay, and none of these parties is a national parties during that time. Okay, moving on to the next question. The Bharat Dacoity was the first major venture of revolutionary terrorist of the freedom movement in which of these following region, that is Bombay, Karnataka, Punjab, East Bengal or the Madras Presidency? So the answer is option number C, that is East Bengal. Okay, so Bharat Dacoity took place at Bara in East Bengal region, in which state treasury was looted. Okay, and Pulin Behari Das was the mastermind behind this conspiracy or this loot. Okay, moving on to the next question. The word Adivasi was used for the first time to refer to the tribal people by whom? That is Mahatma Gandhi, Thakkar Bappa, Jyotiba Phule or B.R. Ambedkar? So the answer is option number B, that is Thakkar Bappa. So basically his name was Amrit Buthal Das Thakkar. And he became a member of Servants of India Society, which was being formed by Gopal Krishna Gokhale in the year 1914. And he was an Indian social worker, and he worked for the upliftment and benefit or development of the downtrodden classes. Okay, so basically he had coined this word Adivasi. Next question. What is the correct sequence of the following events? So there are certain events like the Lucknow Pact, the introduction of Diarchy, the Rowlatt Act or the partition of Bengal. Okay, so what is the current sequence of it? A correct sequence, that is 1324, 4132, 1, 2, 3, 4 or 4, 3, 2, 1. So the answer is option number B, that is 4, 1, 3 and 2. So basically, as we know, the Lucknow Pact, which was being signed on 29th December 1916, the introduction of Diarchy was in the year 1919 on 23rd December 1919. The Rowlatt Act was passed on 19th March 1919 and the partition of Bengal took place on 16th October 1905. So that's the correct sequence of these events. Moving on to the next question. It's a matching. Which of the following pairs is correctly matched? So of these four options, which one is the correctly matched? That is Battle of Buxar, Mir Zafar versus Clive, Battle of Bandiwas, French versus East India Company, Battle of Chilianwala, Dalhousie versus Marathas, Battle of Kharda, Nizam versus East India Company. Okay, so the answer is option number B, that is Battle of Bandiwas, French versus East India Company. So this is the only one which has been correctly matched. Okay, rest three is incorrect because the Battle of Buxar, which took place on 22nd October 1764, it was basically fought between the British East India Company and the combined armies of Mir Qasim, the Nawab of Bengal and the Nawab of Awadh. Okay, and as far as the Battle of Chilianwala is concerned, it was between British East India Company and the Sikh army. Okay, and regarding the Kharda battle, it was between Nizam of Hyderabad and Maratha Confederacy on 11th March 1795. Okay, and it resulted in the victory of the Marathas. Moving on to the next question. So there's a map given here, and there are certain places marked with different numbers like 1, 2, 3 and 4. And which of these powers did rule at these places, like Scindias, Holkars, Gaikwads and Bhosles were those groups. And which place or which region is related to whom? Okay, so the answer is option number B, that is Holkars, Scindias, Gaikwads and Bhosles. Okay, so the number one position that is shows, it's the number one is for, you can say, so the Scindias, they were the power at the Gwalior region. Indore was the territory of the Holkars. Bhosles resided in the Magpur region, and Gaikwads at the Baroda region. Okay, next question. So which one of the following was an emigre communist journal of M. N. Roy? Options are Kisan Sabha, The Worker, Vanguard or Anushilan. Answer is option will be The Worker. Okay, so as we know, M. N. Roy was the founder of communist newspaper Vanguard, and it was a source of candid information for the Indian people about the 1917 October Revolution. Okay, so related to that, the contents were present in this journal. Okay, next question. The residual wing of the Congress Party with Jawaharlal Nehru as one of its main leaders founded the Independence for India League in the opposition to which of the following, that is the Gandhi Vegan Pact, the Home Rule Movement, the Nehru Report or the Montfort Reforms. Okay, so the answer is option number C, that is the Nehru Report. Okay, so as far as the Independence of Indian League was formed with Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose, who opposed Nehru Report, that is 1928, and they wanted to complete independence. So that's the reason why this was opposed. Okay, so with this, friends, we have come to the conclusion of our video. Hope you might have liked this video. You might have got some useful information as far as the prelims exam is concerned. And thank you, friends. Thanks for watching.